Hello. If you don't know me yet, my name is Richard, and for the foreseeable future, I'm trapped in this apartment. Because I live in Madrid, and if you haven't been following the news, which quite frankly in this environment is a bit difficult to do, we're on lockdown as of today. And we've been on and off quarantine for the last few days, given the fact that it's not been an official policy, but it's been recommended. Now it's official. Now, you can start getting into trouble if you're just seen wandering around. And that's sort of the attempt to contain the coronavirus. Now, I want to share my experiences with you because I think a sizable percentage of the globe will sooner or later be in the exact same situation as I'm in, given the fact that this has spread. If it's not already in your country, it'll be there in a few weeks. And if you already have it in your country, you'll be in the exact same situation as I'm in about a month, give or take. So I kind of want to boil the frog, as it were, show you what's in store. Because the first stage is panic buying. Now, I was fortunate enough that I bought all my supplies well over a month ago, given the fact that I'd been reading about social media in China, how people were being welded shut, how the whole thing was spiraling out of control, and I thought it was a matter of time before it reached our shores, so I just decided to preemptively prepare. And this has suited me well, because recently, people are panic buying. Every shelf on the supermarket, gone. And from what I hear, it's already spread to a sizable percentage of the globe. Quite frankly, I don't understand why people are hoarding toilet paper, but it's happening in sizable numbers. Now, I have a bidet, so for the foreseeable future, no matter how bad the apocalypse gets, my bum will be clean. Anyway, but the thing is, you will probably experience what I'm experiencing, and I want to get you up to date. Firstly, if it hasn't gotten to the stage of panic buying, buy supplies now. It's much better to prepare now and not have to use the resources than later when you don't have the ability to get any supplies. I'm always reminded by that phrase in The Lord of the Rings. I think it's the hobbits who are talking with Gandalf. And they start complaining about the fact that their packs are too heavy. And Gandalf, in his grandfatherly way, says, "Well, in a few weeks, you'll have wished that your packs were a bit heavier now." And that phrase has stuck with me over the years since I read it. I realize that right now, if it was much better to overreact, to buy supplies in advance before anything was wrong in the country, than later on when shit has hit the fan and people are getting stabbed in the supermarket for fucking toilet paper. So anyway, this is the situation that we're presently in. A few days ago, all bars, restaurants, etc. were closed off, and now everything except for pharmacies and supermarkets are closed. It hasn't quite dissuaded all Spaniards from going on the streets, and I think measures like in Italy will have to be taken, where if they see you outside and you don't have a certain permit, you are fined and sometimes even put in jail. It's that serious. Because the situation in Italy has gotten something like 5-6% death rate. And they're getting to the point where they're just letting people die. This is not exaggeration on my end. They have literally come and said, if you're over 80 years old, we're sorry, but you're simply just gonna have to fend for yourself, as we simply don't have the capacity. And I suspect that it'll happen soon here in Spain, from what I hear from my friends in the medical field. The system is collapsing. Madrid itself has hired over 1,700 workers, and even that is not enough. The system is simply collapsing, and there's no end in sight. And yeah, it's spreading all around the world. So it's a matter of time before you get... I think this will be the era where modernity is stress tested. All these structures that people had sort of sleepwalked into, the EU, the just-in-time delivery method, where people are just, where goods and services are delivered just in time when needed. Because the thing is, most metropolitan areas do not have the capacity to weather a crisis by themselves, as they only have resources for about a week. So if resources start being scarce, I'm suspecting riots and problems. Even today, I actually started seeing police in front of the supermarket that I live in. My window here allows me to just look and see what is happening, and there's just been a non-stop parade of policemen in front of the supermarket. And I think that's just going to be the new norm. All the centers where there's food will be strictly guarded. Hell, even fucking toilet paper is getting to that point where it has to get security. And shit hasn't really hit the fan. We've yet to reach to that point. But it'll get there. Don't worry. It'll get there sooner or later. And I just don't think that the world has prepared themselves. Say, for example, in the UK, they had the policy of not having a policy. They literally want to have herd immunity, where it's estimated like 60% of the people need to get infected, which, if we're being conservative and you're estimating like a 3.5% death ratio, then that would be well over a million people dead. And just for context, in the UK, during World War II, about 450,000 people died. So if the policies were to work under those circumstances, more people, several times more people than during World War II, will die in the UK. And in the US, the American healthcare system simply does not have the capacity to weather a massive crisis. I think you guys are in for a very interesting ride, to tell you the truth. And same over here, the EU, for example, it's non-existent. It's basically every country for themselves. Fucking China has offered more help than any of the bureaucrats in Brussels. It's every country for themselves, and European unity be damned. So I think after the crisis has been weathered, after the bodies have been tallied, I think people will start to reassess the situation. I think circumstances that we had accepted will have to be readjusted. Maybe it doesn't make sense to have your food production abroad, given the fact that you can't weather a crisis. Maybe to a certain extent it does, but not entirely. Our autarky is simply not the way to go about it. So I think we are living in interesting times. The board is set to change. For example, us millennials, we might actually end up in an era that wholly contrary to what we expected as. Which we sort of gotten used to the idea that there's no job prospects, there's no upwards mobility, and we won't ever be able to buy a house. But all of a sudden, if a sizable percentage of the elderly population dies, the situation might change. So these types of plagues, these types of diseases have a way of upending the status quo. For example, in the medieval era, when the Black Death was destroying society as they knew it, the young people were massively affected. So all of a sudden, when situations started becoming normal, there weren't enough young people. And the ones that there were, they could set their own terms. All of a sudden, the guilds, all of a sudden, the religious institutions that could just have the luxury of not being of being picky, didn't have it. They had to pick whomever was willing. They had to just accept people based on their merit. So, to a certain extent, the Black Death created equality, it created the first inklings of modernity in the places where the plague didn't hit as hard, like Poland, for example. Situations were just, feudalism existed for hundreds of years more. And so that's the thing. These types of diseases have a way of altering how society is run, and I'm quite interested to see what will happen. You also have the opposite. Well, you also have the similar situation where, imagine a politician starts getting emergency powers nowadays, temporary emergency powers. And as we all know, there's no such thing, there's no longer term thing than a temporary solution. So at the end of the day, it might be the case that some politicians that are now getting power because of this emergency will simply stay that way. So, because of its historical context, because of its historical importance, I want to catalog this. I want you to be a part of this journey with me, and we'll see how it goes. So, I'll let you know in the near future how things are going, trapped inside of this room. See you next time.